Y'all outside your kitchen window is up pretty early today? Nice. I'm sure Buddy's loving that. Can't do that while I'm using the quick select. Oops. Too much race. See if I can actually ink this with some pen pressure. no. I imagine like the fins on the head are just like pieces of felt that are stitched on. I should probably do that. And then do cardboard. Could be cardboard. Make him look a little bit tattered. one smooth line from here to the tail. Let's go. Yeah, almost got it. Let's try the other way. Oh, come on. Why does that leg not look right? Thank you. come back to that in a second. Oh, they don't have any, like, tummy marking. Okay, so body, tail. Alright, so that's why that's not looking. Yeah, okay, so the body would end up coming down like that. But then I have the leg up, so you're not gonna see that. Yeah, I mean, that's pretty much right. Hang on, let me look up some more pictures of Vaporeon. I'm terrible at drawing animals. I think it's gonna end up, yeah, it's gonna hide part of the tail too, so it's gonna come down. The hip there, so it's gotta come up higher here. So I'm gonna start here. All that's obscured by the arm. This part of the tail's hidden by the thigh. This is why I love working in vector layers, because I can draw my intersections and then just trim them without having to go in and like redo all the line work. smaller. So cute, make this a real plush cake, thanks. To shrink it down a little bit more just so I can get the hands on a little bit better area. Oh, I forgot to put the puppet ties on his tail. Raggedy Vaporeon. Okay, so I can turn off the initial layer. Alright, so one hand is gonna be here. Something like that. Matching up curves is the hardest thing in the world to do. The only reason why it's hard is because nobody else cares. Except me. If it's, like, not spaced right. I still hate that.
It's inside you.
You know what this reminds me of is the one guy from Naruto that had that puppet jutsu. Okay, this is gonna go behind the face, which means all this gets to go away. Go away. Wait, there's an easier way to do that. Find out where terminates. Erase those. Now I should be able to just select these. Boom.
It's inside you.
And then this one. So many straggly lines. This one is just randomly going down here somewhere. Alright, so that one's going, like, to the head to move the head around. And the one for the tail. And the feet.
It's inside.
Vaporeon stood, patiently drying her sight. Presently, he noticed the gaunt features of something else watching him in the darkened corner. For a moment, two emotions split.
Come on, racer. Really? There we go. That's dumb. So do the middle one goes to the tail.
Technology.
think what would make most sense is this one going here. Beautiful. Just gotta think of how I want to erase these lines to put them in their correct 3D space. So it's twisted over. So I mean, they're definitely behind the arms. And they're going to be in front of both of the legs. Yeah, they gotta be in front of the tail, otherwise everything will get tangled up. I'm assuming its eyes would be like somewhere around, whoops, still got the eraser tool on. I'm assuming its eyes would be somewhere like down here, like underneath the chest, so like he could still see. Because the sprite looks like it has buttons on the eyes. Apparently you don't want to actually like look at one because you'll go crazy. I think I want to make the mouth smaller. Could we like, should the mouth be stitched on? I Like, what if we just put a fake mouth on it? What's the Mimikyu mouth is like a zigzag, right? What if we draw that less shittily? Yeah, I kind of like the way that looks better. Now we're going to play the fun game of where are all the gaps in my line art. You'll know when we find one. Oh, that kind of clash is not great, doesn't it? I guess I should, I shouldn't use anti-aliasing for the line art. I think that's what makes those weird gaps show up. There we go. Fill up to vector path, include vector path. Now we're getting somewhere. That should make it a little less... odd looking. I don't know why it's getting that weird little bleed over there. Oh, wait, I did those backwards? Picked up on coloring. I'm really just mainly working black and white. There we go. So I can see that it's still covered up spots here. I don't know why. Right, it didn't cover up spots here. I left a little gap here too. That's how you draw a Mimikyu Vaporeon, apparently. Mind the gap. Let me just clear screen quick so I can save this.